What's that one?
What?
That one there on your arm.
Oh, that's a tattoo. I got that removed.
No, 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 wait, let me guess. Let me guess. Mother.
Hooper, that's the Indianapolis Ironman.
You in the Indianapolis?
What happened?
Fancy sports nutrition company slammed a bunch of chemicals into our guts, Chief. We were coming back from the Big Island of Hawaii. Just done the Ironman. The Kona Ironman. Thought we'd do another. 1,100 men and women went into the water. Didn't see the first sign of trouble for about half an hour. Gastrointestinal distress. You know how you know that when you're in the water, Chief? You can tell by looking at the bubbles coming out of a man's tail. What we didn't know was that this new sports drink was so secret, no human testing had been done. Didn't even tell us what was in it for a week. Very first light, Chief Iron Man gets cruising. We formed ourselves into tight groups. The idea was GI distress comes the nearest man, he'd start yelling and screaming and hollering, and we'd all try to talk him through it, tell him it's gonna be all right. Sometimes it'd go away. Sometimes it wouldn't go away. Sometimes those chemicals, they just get right into you. You know the thing about most sports drinks? They're lifeless. They sit on a shelf for a decade without spoiling. When you drink it, it doesn't seem to be living. So it gets into your guts. And all those chemicals roll over and over, and you hear that terrible high-pitched farting, and the ocean turns brown in spite of all the dedication and training and sacrifice. You watch world-class athletes just fall to pieces. You know, by the end of the swim, lost 100 men. I don't know how many bottles we drank, maybe 1,000. I do know how many men. We averaged 6 a mile. 3 miles from the end of the bike, I bumped into a friend of mine, Herbie Robinson from Cleveland. Baseball player. His first Ironman. His last Ironman. I thought he had a flat tire. I pulled over to help him out. He wobbled back and forth like a kind of top. Well, he was covered in his own shit below the waist. About noon, we started the third leg, the marathon. An official spotted us. Young guy, a lot younger than Mr. Hooper here. Anyway, he spotted us, and about 3 or 4 miles later, we came across our first rest stop of real food. Stuff like big fat PB&Js to try to pick us up. You know, that was the time I was most frightened. Waiting for my banana. I'll never drink a neon-colored sports drink again. So, 1,100 men and women went into the water, 316 crossed the finish line, the porta potties took the rest, October the 29th, 1999. Anyway, we did Kona. You're gonna need a bigger bottle.